Hi, in this video we're going to solve a couple of problems involving electrical power and energy. In this first problem we're told a stove element has 15 amps flowing through it and there's 240 volts connected across it, and we're going to find out how long it takes to consume 600 kilojoules of energy. So recall from previous discussion that we have this relationship between power and energy, and that the unit of power, the watt, is equal to joule per second, energy per time. So we can start this problem by finding the power for the element. Remember, power is voltage times current. So we have 240 volts times 15 amps, and that equals 3.6 kilowatts. Okay, now to find the amount of time, since we're just dealing with numbers here, we don't have a function for the energy. We don't have to take a derivative or anything. We can just look at this relationship here and see that, well, we can solve for time by just dividing the joules by the watts. So the amount of time it's going to take is just a 600 kilojoules divided by 3.6 kilowatts. And remember, a watt is a joule per second, so just so it's clear that the units will work out here. Okay, I wrote watts as joules per second, so you can see the joules per second cancel out and we'll get seconds, and the numbers work out where it's 166 and two-thirds seconds. Alright, so that answers the first part of the question. The second part of the question is, well, what if the power company charges 13 cents per kilowatt hour? How much would the consumer have to pay for consuming that amount of energy? PG&E and, you know, other power companies, they like to use kilowatt per hour when they do their charging. So we need to take the number of kilowatts that we have, okay, the 3.6 kilowatts, and convert that to kilowatt hours. So we take that, multiply it times 166 and two-thirds seconds, divided by the number of seconds in an hour, which is 3600. Okay, and that comes out, if you work it out, that comes out to approximately a sixth. So I'm just going to write it as a fraction here. So a sixth kilowatt hour. So now we just take our rate, which is 13 cents per kilowatt hour, and multiply that times 1/6 kilowatt hour. So kilowatt hours cancel out, and we're left with approximately a whopping 2.2 cents. So just over a couple of pennies. That's what it would cost us. Okay, so that's the first problem. Let's look at another problem. This problem here, we're told that a satellite battery has a constant amount of current, 4 amps, for a continuous amount of time, 5 hours, and the voltage across the battery is this function here, 20 plus T over 4 volts. And we want to calculate the total amount of battery energy during that 5-hour time interval. So to do this problem, we'll need to do an integration that, as we talked about before, to get energy from power, you just integrate power over a time interval. Also, power is V times I, so that's where we would start here, is that we would take our voltage function, okay, 20 plus T over 4, so T times 4 amps. Okay, so we multiply this out now. I'm going to leave, well, we're going to assume we're starting from an initial time of 0, but I'm going to leave out the top limit here for a moment. But now we multiply this out, we're going to get 80 plus t dt. Okay, so the reason I left out these this upper limit is because this is a common error that's made. Remember that where this 80 plus t came from is that we multiplied voltage times current, right, which is power, and that has units of watts, and watts are joules per second. So you see that means that our dt here, our time, has to be in seconds. A common error is that because the problem statement has 5 hours, you know, a person will put 5 as this upper limit, but then your units aren't going to work out. So that 5 hours has to be in seconds. So if you take 5 hours times 3600, which is the number of seconds in an hour, and we saw that in the previous problem, you'll see that 5 hours is 18,000 seconds, so 18K. Okay, so that's what our upper limit is. So keep an eye out for that on problems like this. So now what you have is, when you integrate this, you'll have 80T and then plus t squared over 2. Okay, and you would evaluate that from 0 to 18K. Okay, so now you got to plug that 18K in for t, and it should come out, and it comes out to a pretty big number here. It comes out to 163.44 megajoules. Remember, the units of energy are joules. Okay, so that would be our answer. So, again, real key point is watch your units here for your limits. Okay, they got to be in seconds, since again, you're doing power, which is joules per second, so you got to multiply by seconds, so you come out with joules.